Hey guys, John from FlyEatMikeAlpha.com, and today we're going to get into part two of METARs and TAFs. This is the more nitty-gritty, meaty part of METARs and TAFs. We're going to focus a lot on the remark section and all those strange abbreviations you don't get to see too often, the ones that really get you on those check rides, especially for commercial and CFI check rides that you just don't get to see a whole heck of a lot until the weather is really bad and you really do need to know what they mean. So we're going to jump right into it.
Key Ann Arbor Tower, right turn northbound approved, runway 24 cleared for takeoff.
Rare contact, squawk 0164, and climb to 2100. Key Ann Arbor Tower, let's keep there. Tower runway 14 cleared away.
Alright, so here's our METAR for Punta Gorda, and it follows that same standard format that they all do. And now we're going to go ahead and focus on the remarks section. Starts off with AO2. What does that mean? Well, that ultimately means that the automated station can distinguish between rain, snow, and etc. If it said AO1, it would mean that it cannot distinguish between rain or snow and so on. So AO2 is just a little bit more sensitive station, more sensors, and it'll let you know the difference between rain or snow or sleet, things like that. Moving along here, PRESFR, pressure falling rapidly. If it was RR instead of FR, that would mean pressure rising rapidly. So just a rapid change in pressure, in this case, warning you about rapidly deteriorating weather or a front passing through. SLP, that's fairly easy. That's a sea level pressure is 1095 millibars. So we add a one in front of that. So that's going to be your millibars for when you're flying. I guess the Europeans use that. We really don't use that in the States. We just use that 29.81, the inches of mercury instead of millibars of mercury. P0003, what that means is how much precipitation has fallen in hundreds of inches over the past hour. So not a whole heck of a lot of precipitation recently. And then T0211094, that ultimately means temperature is 21.1 degrees Celsius, 19.4 degrees Celsius for the dew point. So that just is more specific. Now let's go ahead and talk about sky conditions, remembering back from our private pilot training. SKC means sky clear, but that would only be for a manual observation. Somebody would have to manually input SKC. If we saw CLR, that would be from an automated station, and it means clear below 12,000, 12,000 feet. Could be overcast 13,000, but below there it's totally clear. Few clouds would be 0 to 2/8, or basically 1/8 or 2/8 of the sky covered. Scattered, 3/8 or 4/8 of the sky covered. Broken, 5 to 7/8, so 5/8, 6/8, 7/8. And overcast would be 8/8 of the sky. If you saw VV instead of one of these types of sky conditions, that means vertical visibility. So indefinite ceiling, but basically just the ceiling's obscured or your visibility is obscured, how high you're gonna be able to see up into the sky. Vertical visibility might just be 100 or 200 feet, almost like as if the clouds are at the surface, very low visibility, and there's no defined ceiling, but you do lose ground contact after 50 or 100 or 200 feet, so on. So cloud types that they might also include in there, CB will be cumulonimbus present. So whenever we see CB, we watch out. TCU would be even worse. That's towering cumulus present. So cumulonimbus means rain cumulus clouds. Towering cumulus are about to be bad thunderstorms. If they're towering, they're tall, they're strong, and it may not be raining yet. So TCU is something also to definitely watch out for. Next thing to note is this says METAR. It's a standard report issued once an hour. If we saw SPECI, S-P-E-C-I, that would stand for it was a special report issued either because of a huge change in weather that they wanted to update or for some other reason it was specially issued, not at the standard time. Now let's go ahead and talk about runway visual range, and you'll get into this as especially as you start flying instruments or at your commercial and CFI level. Runway visual range is exactly what it sounds like. How far down the runway can you see? It's going to be displayed in the METAR right after the visibility, so right after, you know, half a mile visibility or right after 3 miles of visibility, 3 SM. it would say R32L/1,000 feet. That stands for runway 32L or 32 left has 1,000 feet of visual range. If it said R06L 2,000 V 4,000 feet, that stands for runway 6 left has 2,000 feet bearing to 4,000 feet visual range down the runway. If it said M0600 feet, that would be it's less than 600 feet, so very little visibility. P6,000 feet, greater than 6,000 feet, they don't determine anything beyond that. And then you just rely on your in-flight visibility or your 2SM, your 3SM, 3 statute miles, whatever it might be. Now let's go ahead and talk about the description about the weather phenomenon. And this is probably a good place to pause and take some notes. Basically, minus means light. If there's no symbol, it would be moderate, and a plus would be heavy. VC stands for in the vicinity. If there doesn't say VC, then you assume it's right at the station. MI, shallow. PR, partial. BC, patches. DR, low drifting. BL, blowing. SH, showers. FZ, freezing. And TS, thunderstorm. So now let's go ahead and talk about the types of weather phenomenon. Precip types would be DZ, drizzle. RA, rain. SN, snow. SG, snow grains. IC, ice crystals. PL, ice pellets. GR for hail that's greater than a quarter inch in diameter, and GS for small hail, or just larger snow pellets, but small hail less than a quarter inch in diameter. Now, for what type of obscuration we have to the visibility, we have BR for mist, FG, fog, FU, smoke, VA, volcanic ash, DU, dust, SA, sand, HZ, haze, PY, spray, and UP for unknown precipitation type. Now for some bonus points here. Other types of designations you might see that are a little less common. PO equals well-developed dust or sand whirls. SQ for squalls. FC for funnel cloud, tornadoes, waterspouts, watch out. SS, sandstorm. And DS, dust storm. Now lastly, we're going to go over some remarks that we don't see quite so often in our METARs, but can show up from time to time. So WSHFT is a wind shift, and WSHFT45 would be a wind shift at 45 minutes past the hour. FROPA would be a frontal passage. Peak wind 34050/38, that means peak wind 340 degrees at 50 knots, and it occurred at 38 minutes past the hour. Then this whole long thing here, RAB 05E30, and then snow, and so on. It means rain began 5 minutes past the hour, ended 30 minutes past the hour, snow began 20 minutes past the hour, and ended at 55 minutes past the hour. So it's just a begin-end remark, kind of a longer one there. This one right below it, rain and snow began at 20 minutes past the hour and ended 55 minutes past the hour. So rain and snow began both at 20 minutes past the hour and ended together. PWINO is present weather identifier not available. Basically, weather sensors inoperative. FZ RAINO, freezing rain, we can assume that. So freezing rain info not available is what that means. The freezing rain sensor is inop. TSB05E30 is thunderstorm began 5 minutes past the hour, ended 30 minutes past the hour, just a begin-end remark again. TSNO, that's a pretty common one. Thunderstorm info not available. The lightning detection system's inoperative on the AWOS or ASOS or whatever they have in the field. Occasional, OCNL, just means occasionally, so you might see occasional lightning. And that would be less than one flash a minute. FRQ would be frequent, 1 to 6 flashes a minute. CONS, continuous, greater than 6 flashes a minute, so lots of lightning. CG, cloud to ground lightning. IC, in cloud lightning. CC, cloud to cloud. CA, cloud to air. CBW, moving east, that'd be cumulonimbus clouds, west moving to the east. CB, MAM, distant south, that's cumulonimbus clouds, mammatus, distant to the south, and that's just a type of cumulonimbus cloud. TCU overhead, towering cumulus overhead, that'd be bad. That's when you can expect some microbursts or downdrafts when those thunderstorms are directly overhead. TCU west, towering cumulus to the west. ACC west, altocumulus, Castellanus to the west. And Castellanus is just another type of cumulus cloud. Almost done here, stick with us. ACSL-SSW, that's altocumulus standing lenticular clouds south through southwest. CCSL over mountain to the east, that's cirrocumulus standing lenticular clouds over the mountains to the east, in case you were curious. Virga is simple, that's just Virga at the station. That's basically rain that doesn't touch the ground, it evaporates before it hits the ground. You can Google that if you want more information. Virga distant to the northeast, it just means Virga is distant to the northeast. Tower Vis 1, tower visibility is 1 mile. SFC Vis 2.5, that's surface visibility, 2.5 miles. Vis 2, runway 11, that's visibility 2 miles at runway 11 or 11. Vis 1V2, visibility is varying between 1 and 2 statute miles. Vis N2, that's visibility to the north, is 2 miles, sector visibility. So maybe it's good 4 or 5 mile visibility at the field, but off to the north, it is 2 mile visibility. And that is it for the METAR remarks abbreviation section. You stuck with us. Hopefully you took good notes. Thanks so much for sticking with us here. If you have any questions at all, you should have some questions on these. Leave them in the comments below. Give us a thumbs up on the video. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up with all our latest episodes. And we hope you get to fly every day. If not, then fly@mikealpha.com. See y'all next time.